Hello students, last time we have dealt with the empirical formula and molecular formula definition, and we have also seen that what's the relationship between empirical formula and molecular formula. Now we will move to the next part of this, like if the percentage by mass of the elements which are present in the compound, it is provided to us, then how can we find out the molecular formula or empirical formula? So there are certain steps. Like if the percentage mass of any element is given to you, then how with the help of these percentage you can find out the empirical formula, and with the help of this empirical formula we have seen that we can easily find out the molecular formula of the compound. So now first of all we will be learning the steps that how this percentage concentration can be converted into empirical formula. So that are the steps. The very first step is, as we are given with the percentage of the elements present in the compound, so first we divide these percentage of elements with their atomic mass so that we can find out the molar ratio of these elements which are present in the compound. The very first step is, to get molar ratio of elements. Now, as we have the molar ratio of these elements, they can be used to write the subscript of atoms and we will be finding the empirical formula. But as we know that empirical formula is the simplest molar ratio of elements, so if these molar ratio are not in the simplest form, we will be dividing the ratio of these elements with the least value of this molar ratio. So the next step is, divide this molar ratio with the least value of any element. And this thing we are doing to get the simplest ratio of elements so that we can use this to represent the empirical formula of the compound. Now, as we have divided this to get the simplest ratio, sometimes it is possible that the ratio is not the whole number ratio. And as we have seen that whenever we write the empirical formula, the subscript is always a whole number value. So in the next step, to get this the whole number simplest ratio, we multiply this value with the value so that to get the whole number value. So that this the condition is, we will be applying the third rule, the third step, only in that condition if any of the molar ratio has the fractional value. That is, if any of the molar ratio has fractional value, then we can multiply this with a suitable number to get the whole number value. And while doing this thing, you are to be careful about the thing that whatever the value you are using here for the multiplication, you are to do the same thing for the another elements also, so that you can find the simplest ratio of atoms present in the compound. Now let's apply these steps by taking a compound. Like, if the question is provided to us, there is the percent, a compound contains carbon and hydrogen, and you are provided with the mass percentage of these two elements. So if the mass percentage of carbon, that is 75%, it is provided to us, and the mass percentage of hydrogen, that is the another constituent of this compound, it is provided as 25%. And with the help of these two given percentage, we are asked to calculate the empirical formula of the compound. So, as we are provided with the percentage of these elements, the very first column I am going to make for the element, the elements are carbon and hydrogen. And the mass percentage for these two is As this is the next thing that is provided to us, the percentage by mass is 75% and 12%. To get the simplest molar ratio, we are to divide this percentage by mass with the atomic mass. So that is percentage by mass. Now we need to divide this with the atomic mass. That is the very first step. As we multiply this 75 with the atomic mass of carbon, the value is 12. And the second thing is percentage by mass. That is not 12%. Here the value is given as 25%. So now we will be dividing this with the atomic mass of hydrogen, that is 1. Here the value comes as 6.25, and as we can see here, the value will be 25. Now the least value out of these two is 6.25, and to get the simplest ratio, now we will be dividing these two molar ratio with the value of 6.25. So that is the ratio of element. You are to divide this with the minimum value. The value will be 6.25. We are to divide this with the minimum value, that is the same 6.25. The ratio will be 1, and the second molar ratio of this hydrogen is 25. To get the simplest ratio, we need to divide this with 6.25. As we go for the calculation here, the value will be 4. So that is the simplest ratio of carbon and hydrogen present in this compound, and both the values are whole number value, so we need not to go for the third step. And the final empirical formula will be containing 1 atom of carbon as well as 4 atoms of hydrogen, so that can be written as CH4, and this one is the representation for the empirical formula of this compound. So that is how we can apply these steps for the given percentage concentration. Now we will move for the next compound, for the next example, for the practice of these given steps. In the next question, again the compound contains carbon, hydrogen, but now this time this compound contains oxygen also, and the percentage by mass of these three elements is given as, the very first carbon, it has the percentage 40.687%. The next one is hydrogen, the percentage is given as 5.085%, and the last one is percentage of oxygen. If nothing is said, we are to take that this percentage is given as percentage by mass, and the percentage by mass of oxygen is 54.28228%. Now here the molecular mass of this compound is also provided to us. The molecular weight of compound is given as 118 amu, and with the help of these all datas, we are to find out first the empirical formula of the compound, and then we are to find out the molecular formula of the compound. So these two are unknown to us. Now we will be making a table for the steps. We will be making a table in which we will be doing the calculation according to the steps we have read earlier. So the very first column is, we will be talking about the elements. In the next one, we will be dividing these elements with the atomic mass of these, percentage by mass, divide this with the atomic mass. That will give you the molar ratio of these atoms. And in the next system, we will be dividing this molar ratio with the minimum value. As we get the simplest ratio of these, now if the ratio is whole number, we can directly use this. But if it is not, we are to convert this into the whole number ratio. So these are the steps, and now we are to move according to this. The very first, we will be talking about the carbon. The percentage of carbon is given as 40.687%, and the atomic mass of carbon is 12. As we go for the ratio of these two, the value will come as 3.39. Now if I move for the next one, that is hydrogen, the percentage of the hydrogen is given as 5.085, and the atomic mass of hydrogen is 1, so the value will come as 5.085. If I talk about the oxygen, so the oxygen has the percentage 54.228, and the atomic mass of oxygen is 16, so the value comes as 3.39 again. As we can find that out of these three molar ratio, the least value is 3.39. So now we will be dividing this molar ratio 3.39 with the least value, that is again the same. The ratio will come as 1. Now if we go for the next one, hydrogen, the value is 5.085. If I divide this with the least value 3.39, ratio comes as 3/2, that is 1.5, and the third one is 3.39. We have to divide this with the least value. The ratio comes at 1. This is the ratio of these atoms in the simplest form. But as the ratio is not the whole number ratio, the value comes as 1.5. So to convert this into the whole number value, we need to multiply this by 2. And the same thing we will be doing for the rest two atoms also. We need to multiply all these this simplest molar ratio with the value of, finally the ratio will come as 2:3:2. And if we arrange that as the subscript of atoms, the ratio will come as C2. 3 atoms of hydrogen, as well as it contains 2 atoms of oxygen. So this is the simplest ratio of atoms present in the compound, and that can be written as the empirical formula of the compound. Now the next part of this question was, we were also asked to calculate the molecular formula of the compound. So now, to calculate the molecular formula, as we have seen last time, we need to find out the value of N, where this N is equals to molecular mass of the compound. Divide this with the empirical formula mass of the compound. The molecular mass of the compound is given to us 118. And if I talk about the empirical formula mass, so this is the empirical formula. And empirical formula mass will be equals to, since the empirical formula contains 2 atoms of carbon, the contribution of carbon will be 24 amu. 3 atoms of hydrogen, they will contribute 3 amu. And 2 atoms of oxygen will contribute 32 amu. The sum of these all is equals to 59 amu. That is the empirical formula mass. And as we divide this with the empirical formula mass, the value will come as, if we multiply this empirical formula, the number of each atom with the value 2, finally we will be getting the empirical the molecular formula with the help of empirical formula, and the value comes at C4H6O4, and the C4H6O4 indicates the actual number of atoms present in the compound. So here this is the molecular formula of the compound, and this is about that, how can we calculate the molecular formula with a given percentage.